Now, if you have Python installed on your own machine and you have some kind of a terminal or shell in which you can get a command prompt, you can type the command Python and then give it the minus M flag, which says module, and then load what's called the C profile module, lowercase c, uppercase p, and then the name of your file that you want to profile. I called my cryptarithmetic file crypt.py. Execute that, and you'll get a nice table of where all the time goes. Now, if you don't have Python installed, or you can't run a command like this, you can do it from within Python. And what you'll have to do is say import the cprofile module, and then do cprofile.run, and then a string to be evaluated, which is the code that you want to run. And then you'll see output that looks like this. So in the right-hand column, we see the various functions that are being called. Within my crypt program, there are three main functions, solve, fill in, and valid. And then within the regular expression module, I was calling search and compile. And then there's various other built-in methods of Python, such as the string make-trans function, the eval function, and so on. These other columns tell us the number of times each of these functions was called, the total time spent, some percentage, we won't worry about that, or that's time per call, then the cumulative time, the total number of times spent there. So mostly I was just calling solve, that was about 75 seconds, and within that 62.7 seconds went to valid, so that's where most of the time is going. So I should say that most of these results are pretty much what I was expecting. I was a little bit surprised that the RE search took so much time, 12 seconds out of the 75. And I was also a little bit surprised that this make-trans and these other methods, the translate methods, took so little time, just about 3 seconds altogether. If we want to make our program faster, it seems obvious that we better look where the time is. And out of that 75 seconds, 63 of it is within valid. So that's where we have to look. And of valid, 47 seconds is within eval. If we want to make our program faster, it makes sense to concentrate our efforts on the parts where most of the time is. And it's not just a good idea, it's the law. It's called the law of diminishing returns. And the way the law works, if we imagine our total execution time as being this bar here, and if we said that goes up to 75 seconds, 63 of those seconds was taken up by the call to valid, and 10 seconds was taken up by fill in, and then all the rest by everything else, we can see if we want to make things faster, we better make this bar shorter, or maybe this bar, and it won't help much to make these other bars shorter. So for example, if we made fill in and everything else vanishingly small, then if we didn't touch valid, we'd still have an execution time of 63 seconds, even if we could improve these infinitely fast, and we wouldn't have helped all that much.